Welcome to another edition of TGIM. That's right, coming at you live and direct once again. It's your boy E.T., the motivator, your personal life coach and inspirator. Listen to me, I have something very, very important for you. I know I'm usually standing up, a lot of energy, but I'm a little laid back today because what I want to do for you today is really give you the secret to E.T.'s success. Once in a while when I'm doing consulting work and we get to the question and answer portion, you know, people ask me, for real, E., what is the secret to your success? And I know I'll give you a lot of principles, but today I want to share with you the secret to success. All right, you've heard me allude to it before, but I'm going to be very specific today. That information changes situations. My mother used to always say, insanity is doing the same thing over and over and over, expecting different results. And when I was a high school dropout, you know, when I was homeless, when I was not operating at the level of success I operate with today, I'm going to tell you the thing that I did not do. And I already alluded to it. I was a high school dropout. I did not read. And I never forget in my teacher's class, she used to have readers are leaders, right? And I didn't pay attention to it. But I want you to know today that the secret to my success is reading. That information truly changes situations. Let me give you an example. I was at the University of Cincinnati speaking. As a matter of fact, I introduced one of my favorite authors, Dr. Naeem Akbar. All right. And before I introduced him, I had actually read his books, right? Was, you know, really up on, you know, the works of this great psychologist. But then after I finished speaking, right, the crowd clapping, there's about 1,800 people there. They were clapping, excited. Afterwards, I met a gentleman in the lobby. As a matter of fact, two guys, Rodney Patterson and Murray Edwards. And these guys gave me a card, you know, and Murray called me and said, I'm doing a conference and I'd love to have you come. All right. At that time, I was probably making about $500 a speech, only $500. And I read somewhere that when somebody calls you and asks you to speak, you never negotiate then. You say that I'll call you back in 24 hours. Why? You want to be deep, right? I knew I didn't have any engagements. He asked me, was I available to speak, what my schedule was like. I was like, I got to get with my agent, check my schedule, and I'll get back with you. Information changes situations. 24 hours exactly to the minute. I picked up that phone and I called Murray Edwards back because I knew I didn't have a speaking engagement, right? And he asked me how much I charge. I said, I usually charge $2,000. He said, I can't give you two, but I'll give you $1,800. Had I spoke to him the day of, I would have only said $500. But I learned from reading that there's a negotiation style. You have to learn how to negotiate your price. So that's one small example of what I mean when I say that information changes situations. So principle number one from The Outliers. In chapter two, man, Malcolm Gladwell says that talent is not enough. That sheer talent alone will never take you to the next level. What he says is talent plus time. Talent plus preparation equals greatness. As a matter of fact, if you read his book, you can go to page 41, and he talks about at the end that you have to put in 10,000 hours. He says that every great hockey player, every great musician, even he says up into Mozart, the greatest musician prodigy of all times, couldn't hit his stride until he reached 10,000 hours in practice. So that's my first principle, guys. You got to catch it. That's where my principles come from. They come from reading that talent alone is not enough. And you're saying, Eric, why have I not reached that next level? You probably haven't put in 10,000 hours. And I got another secret for you. Michael Jackson and the other greats, they didn't start when they were adults. They got in 10,000 hours because they started when they were young. So if you're watching this TGIM and you're saying, I'm not where I want to be in life, I have not reached my goals, I have not accomplished the destiny that I know that was set out for me, may I remind you that you might only be at 8,000 hours. You might only be at 9,000 hours. And so what you need to do again, no, you don't want to hear it, cut the TV off and get to the 10,000 hours. Cut the video games out and get to the 10,000 hours. Matter of fact, cut out the excess sleep. You're sleeping too much. Cut it out. Cut it out and get to your 10,000 hours. All right, my second principle comes from my man, 50 Grand, one of the greatest writers right now and contributors to leadership, and that's John C. Maxwell. I read this book about maybe 7 or 8 years ago, and it's the 21 most important minutes in a leader's day. One of the things that I learned was that you have to fail forward. That's right, it's one thing to fail, it's another thing to fail forward. He says, number one, you have to be big enough to admit your mistakes, all right? Number two, you have to be smart enough to profit from them. And the most important one, I think, is the final one. You have to be strong enough to correct them. He says, knowing you err is essential to correcting mistakes. But if you can't implement the necessary changes in your life, you won't be able to improve yourself or your situation. So my second principle, listen to me, reading is critical. Information changes situations. And if you don't want to continue to repeat the same errors, you got to get different information in. Bad information in, bad information out. Good information in, good information out. Great information in, great information out. My last book, Brother West, one of my greatest inspirations, Cornel West. This is his new book, Living and Loving Out Loud. Let me tell you what I love about this book. Everything, all right? Cornell is a scholar, a black intellect, and so I love it. You got to get it. Again, Living Out Loud. So do yourself a favor. Got four quick things. I'm going to let you go. Number one, read. This summer, I want you to dedicate yourself, give yourself time. I need you to accomplish at least 3 books. That's what I said. This summer, I need you to read at least 3 books. So do yourself a favor, write it down. These are the 3 books. You can use my 3, John C. Maxwell, Malcolm Gladwell, The Outliers, and again, Cornell has 1,000,001 books you can read. Number 2, I need you to go to the conference this year. I need you to go to 1 conference this year. Very critical, all right? If you want to change your situation, you got to get in new information. And that's what conferences will do for you, all right? I recommend John C. Maxwell. He has some very powerful, powerful conferences on leadership and just improvements in life, period. Another thing I want to encourage you to do, if you don't like to read, get the audio book. That's right, on your iPod, your MP3 player. For those of you who still, for whatever reason, you have tape cassettes, all right, or you have CDs in your car, please, if you don't like to read, but you still need to get the information in, I need you to do yourself a favor and get the book online. Final one, an accountability partner, all right? Not only do you need to read the books, all right, it's very important to have somebody you can sit down with and dialogue, discuss the book, all right? That's very important. So once again, it's your homie E.T., the motivator, inspirator, and your life coach. Thanks for tuning in to another Thank God It's Monday. And remember that readers are achievers and readers are leaders. So do yourself a favor, pick up a book because information changes situations. I'm out. I'll see you next Monday. Hey, I want to give a special shout out to Myron Edmonds, Pastor Edmonds. Thank you so much. Man, thank you for telling me about the book. You my man, 50 Grand, Myron Edmonds, The Outliers. Thank God it's Monday.